DeepSeek's AI models are all over the news right now. I mean, everyone's talking about them, but no one wants to use their web UI because, well, they're worried about their privacy. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to deploy a DeepSeek model onto an EC2 instance using Docker, Olama, and Nginx. Let's go. Now, I'm going to be using AWS, but you can follow these steps with most other cloud providers. The first thing we're going to do is launch an EC2 instance. We'll give it a name, make sure Amazon Linux is selected, then we're going to scroll down and change the instance type. Now, ideally, I would have loved to use the G4DN instance type, but for some reason, AWS gives me this error whenever I try to use it. If you have access to it, then you should follow this article to get the most out of this instance type. But for now, I'm going to use the R5XLarge, which is slow because it doesn't have a GPU, but it should be good enough for this tutorial. Next, we'll scroll down and select or create an existing key pair if you don't have one. Then we'll scroll down again and tick allow HTTPS and allow HTTP traffic. We'll change this to 20 just to be on the safe side. After that, we should be good to go. So we'll launch this instance. Next, we'll connect to this instance by clicking on the instance and then clicking on connect. Then we'll copy this, then we'll paste what we copied, and we'll make sure to change the path to where our PEM is and hit enter. Type in yes and hit enter again. And now we should be connected to our EC2 server. Next, we're going to install Docker and Olama. We'll first install Docker by running these commands. The first is going to update yum. The second is going to install Docker. This command will let us use Docker without typing sudo. Then these two commands will enable and start the Docker service in systemctl. Finally, we'll change the permissions of the Docker socket so that we can have access to it. And once this is done, we should be able to type in docker ps and see some results. Now, we don't have any containers running, so let's go ahead and install Olama. We can do that by running this command, which will first run the container in detached mode, then add a volume, which is Olama here. It will then publish the port, so 11434, so we can have access to it, then name the container Olama and use the Olama image. Now, if we run Docker PS, we should see that our Olama container is running. Nice. And if we curl this port, it should say Olama is running. Awesome. Let's now install a DeepSeek model onto Olama. Olama is a tool that lets you run different open source models like DeepSeek, and we're going to install a specific DeepSeek model onto Olama. Olama provides a lot of different DeepSeek models with different parameters, but for this video, we're going to install both the 1.5 Quin distilled, and also down here, we're going to install the 7B Quin distilled. A distilled model is a smaller, more efficient version of a larger model. And Q4KM is the method used to distill or compress the model. Of course, there's also the Q80 method and the FP16. But the Q4KM is kind of a middle ground between these two, where FP16 provides the best results and uses the most amount of resources, and Q80 provides less good results and uses much less resources. Let's go back to our terminal. And we can install it using this command. This process will take some time, so I'm going to fast forward the video to when it's finished. Cool, now we're going to install the Olama Web UI so that we can interact with these models. I'm going to run this command, which again is going to run the container in detached mode, export port 8080 onto port 3000, add a host, add a volume, and name the container Olama Web UI using this image. Cool, we're almost done. The third and final step is to install Nginx. Personally, I'm a huge fan of Kadi, but installing Kadi on Amazon Linux has a few more extra steps. So we're going to keep it simple and install Nginx. We'll first run this command to install Nginx, and then we're going to edit the Nginx config with Vim, or you can use Nano, whatever you prefer. Inside the config, let's scroll down to about here on the include, and we're just going to add this code. Let's format it a tiny bit. And what this is going to do is it's going to forward all requests from the root, so port 80, to localhost 3000. Let's save and exit. We'll test the config with this command and everything looks okay. So we're going to enable and start Nginx. Nice, and that's it. We can now exit from our session. Let's go back to our AWS console in the browser. We'll go to our EC2 instance and then we're going to click on open address. And before you freak out because the site isn't working, don't worry, there's one thing we need to change. Let's change the address here from HTTPS to HTTP. And nice, we have access to an Olama login page. Let's go ahead and sign up. We can make up some credentials like test, and we can put in a password. Cool. And now we have access to both of our models and we can ask it a question. If all goes well, it should give us a response. How cool is this? DeepSeek running in an EC2 instance, and we don't have to worry about privacy. Now, I know this could be made loads better by using a higher parameter model and by using an instance type that has a GPU. And of course, you can go ahead and do that. But for now, this is a good start. If you want to know more about DeepSeek, then check out these videos. Links will be in the description. But until then, be sure to like and subscribe for more of this content.